Alexander Fadeev's 2 Minutes on Ice was one of the finest he had ever produced. The defending world champion looked to be on his way to yet another world title. Fadeev, coming off a disappointing second place finish in January's Europeans, was out to prove he could win the Worlds 2 times in a row. As Brian Orser kept one eye on Fadeev, he knew that his 5th place after figures meant he would have to skate close to perfect 6s in the short. When Fadeev finished, the crowd applauded what looked like an unbeatable routine. American Brian Boitano's short was only 5th best.
Orser, who's been called the best free skater in the world, had the crowd on his side.
The judges' awards. Brian Orser had won the short, and so he stood 3rd overall. So the standings entering the free skates. Orser in 3rd, Boitano in 4th, Alexander Fadeev up top.
CBS Sports Sunday is sponsored by Michelob Light, super premium taste and less filling beer. IBM typewriters, no matter how you look at typing, we're your type. And by Mars Bar, it's the little rewards that make life great, and Mars Bar is one great little reward.
Quiet nights by firelight and Mars roasting almonds. These are
Fadeev, Union Soviet. On the ice here at the World Figure Skating Championships, 22-year-old Soviet skater Alexander Fadeev, the defending world champion, first entering the free skating, which means at this point, he has a better chance than anyone in the arena of winning the gold.
He won this championship. It's one of the most difficult free skating programs ever done in men's competition. He's going to open up the triple lutz jump. Triple lutz, double loop. He does it very well. Next is the most difficult move, triple axel. And he steps out of it, but he recovered with a double salchow. Working a triple flip, and he puts his hand down. There's 2 mistakes in a row. He's kind of opening the door for a good routine to beat him.
Remember, Brian Boitano, Brian Orser, the Canadian, Josef Sobavchik still the skates. This free skating program again counts a full 50%. If Fadeev skates it well, he will win the gold medal.
Well, so far, he hasn't looked as invincible as he was last year. Another triple axel attempt. He missed the last one. Oh, and he 2-foots and puts his hand down. That's 3 mistakes in a row. His next jump, a triple toe loop. And he pulled 4 revolutions. That was a quadruple toe loop. He must have tried that out of desperation. After the 3 misses, he must have felt the only way to win this thing was with a quad toe, and it was a gamble that didn't pay off because he went down.
No one has ever successfully completed a 4-revolution jump in competition. If he had hit that,
it might have made a difference. It might have made the difference. It could have brought up his technical mark. He is not skating well, and he is leaving the door open for the other competitors. Done. If he's going to get back on track, he's got to do it now because he's made a lot of mistakes. Double axel, combination ending in triple toe loop, and he barely pulled it off.
Thank you.
next jump, a triple loop jump. Oh, and he falls. He is not anywhere near the quality he was last year. He's been having a rough week in practice, and it's showing up in this performance. Just having a nightmare.
Well, you said he was erratic. Fadeev misses a few jumps early on, then tries a quadruple jump, and then that fall. And very quickly, the competition has opened up because Orser, Boitano, and Sabovchik are still to skate. Sabovchik in second place, Orser in third. Orser, probably the best free skater of all of them, won the short and the long programs in the Olympics, and maybe this could be his chance to finally win the gold of the World Championships.
I don't think Alexander's going to stop him. You can see he's not pushing very hard anymore, and he lost a lot of the fire in his performance.
Minutes is a long time to be on the ice if you're not skating well. It
takes a lot of stamina. Good performance for Alexander Fadeev.
Alexander Fadeev may well have cleared and paved the road to gold for Orser, Boitano, or Sabovchik still to skate. I wonder what's on his mind at this point.
He's got to be hurting. He made so many mistakes, and then the desperation attempt in the quadruple toe loop. Take another look at that triple axel. It goes up, and you can see he didn't start rotating until too late, and he came up just a little bit short, and he barely pulled it off. Here's that quad. One, two, three, four, and you can see he only got 3.5 times around, and there was no way he had a prayer at landing that jump.
He has actually had several quadruple attempts, but none were ever ratified by the ISU, so he's done it before. His marks for 10. Look at the Soviet judge. The Soviet judge gives Alexander Fadeev a 5-9, one-tenth away from a perfect 6.0, but the rest of the scores are pretty much the same. And you can guess at this point what those boos are for.
That 5-9 is an irresponsible mark. I mean, he fell twice.
There's the Soviet judge. Artistic impression and a low of 5-4 from the Canadian and the Italian judge. Boy, this opens the door for all three of the skaters that are to come. And look at Fadeev, he knows it. Alexander Fadeev with the gold in the palm of his hand a few moments ago. And now it may well be history. Brian Boitano, who was fourth entering the free skate, is still to come. He has a chance at a medal. Don't go away. About 3 weeks before the U.S. Nationals, but he came back to win that competition. Here in Geneva, he was fifth in the short, and we asked him about that.
It was a real accomplishment for me to go out and know that I had my injury and know that I couldn't do all the training before and still pull off a short program. I think that was a real large hump in this competition that I got over, and I'm really happy with myself for that.
Well, now, look, you're in fourth place, and you obviously want to win. That's got to be on your mind. Can you do it?
I haven't talked to anybody about, you know, what such and such has to place or whatever, but I'm going to go for it. No matter if I can win by the marks or not, I'm going to go for winning the freestyle.
From the United States, the U.S. national champion for the last 2 years, 22-year-old Brian Boitano from Sunnyvale, California. Fourth entering the free skating, which counts 50% of the total.
You are looking at a guy that nobody likes to compete against because he is so consistent. Opening jump, a triple lutz. And watch this landing. He holds it to show control. Beautiful triple lutz. Thank you. jump, the most difficult jump of his program, triple axel. Beautifully done in a double toe loop. He is on.
This program and the performance is starkly different from Soviet Alexander Fadeev.
There's life, there's energy, and he is so on top of everything he's doing. Triple toe, double toe, double loop.
Skating, Boitano virtually had no chance for the gold medal. But after that performance, disastrous performance by the Soviet Fadeev, there's an outside chance for the gold, a very good chance for the silver. And the interesting thing is that Boitano was injured before the U.S. Nationals and was off skates for about 3 weeks. He did skate there to win his second consecutive title. He told me that since Nationals, he's been traveling 2 hours a day to get acupuncture and ultrasound on his landing foot.
Triple flip, double toe. There's nothing wrong with his landing foot now.
Boitano's best performance at the World Championships was last year when he won a bronze medal. He has every chance today of winning a silver or a gold.
That's my favorite part about Brian. So come out at the end of his program and do something matter of fact. Just matter of fact, triple salchow, and thank you. More enjoyable when you're on the ice when you know you skate about as well as you can. I'm really happy for him.
It is obvious there are a whole lot of Americans in this arena here in Geneva.
About as good a performance as Brian Boitano could ask for.
There is one happy young man. Brian Boitano knows it. He has skated the best free skating program so far in this competition. He must wait for his marks, but that was, as you said, as clean as he's ever skated.
It was beautiful. Let's take another look at that opening triple axel. Count the rotations. Takes off forward. It'll rotate 3.5 times. The height, the tightness in the air, 1, 2, 3.5, down, 1 foot, clean, and throws a double toe loop on for good measure.
Now, what about the score? Technical America. 2.59s, Coitano. 2.59s, the rest are 5.8s.
Those are great marks. Those 5.9s are really representative of Brian's technical ability. Great marks.
Well, that just decimates the performance by Fadeev and the marks, the technical merit that he got. Artistic impression will follow low scores. There's his coach, Linda Lever.
5.8, 5.8, 5.8, 5.8, 5.8, 5.9.
Boy, that could be good enough for the silver. Who knows at this point? We still have Orser and Sabovchik to skate. And we still have Brian's artistic impression scores to wait for. Here they come. Two more 5.9s. The rest are 5.8s. The same scores as he got for technical merit.
Those are great marks, but there's still a lot of room. Those 5.8s are still going to sneak some 5.9s in, and Brian Orser is still considered the favorite here. Show you Brian's technical ease and ability. Triple flip, 1, 2, 3, no problem. And another double toe loop.
5.9, 5.8, 5.8.
Beautiful combination.
Thank you.
He's on his way now to John Misha Petkovic.
Brian, I don't think I've seen you skate better.
I'm really pleased with how I skated. I think all things considered, it was the best of the year.
You know, it looked like everything was working perfectly for you.
Yeah, I felt that way. Everything was just clicking. Actually, I think it really helped that there was so much commotion after Fadiev's number.
Well, listen, you're standing now in first place. Few skaters left to go. What are your hopes?
To be first place in the long. And then it really doesn't matter too much where I place overall. I just really wanted to get that first place in the long.
Well, upcoming Olympic bronze medalist Josef Sabovchik. We'll be back with more skating after this message and a word from your local station.
Josef Sabovchik, Czechoslovakia.
From Czechoslovakia, the Olympic bronze medalist Josef Sabovchik, the man with the quad. All the talk this week has been about Josef's injury to his knee.
Well, he comes down so low on some of his landings that it really tears up the inside of his knee. The first two jumps he performs will set the pace on whether he'll try the quadruple or not. His first jump. And he popped it into a single.
Sabovchik, second entering the free skating program.
Triple flip and he falls. It's tough to think about your jumping and just relax when you're having so many problems with your knee. Triple toe loop.
Sabovchik told me before his short program that his knee was still bothering him. It has been for 3 years. He's had it wrapped.
Every year he comes to the World Championship. By the time he gets here from all the training, his knee is just torn apart and he can never go on tour at the World Champions after the competition.
Thank you. remember at this moment, as you see Zabavchik skate, the American Brian Boitano still stands in first place, followed by the Soviet Alexander Fadeev.
Josef doesn't seem to be putting out very well. I mean, emotionally, he looks flat. Double loop meant to be a triple. Doesn't seem like he has any strength left, and he's really starting to favor that right leg.
We actually saw him limping a little bit in the warm-ups.
It's really hurting him. You can really tell. You can see it in his face, and you can see it in the way he's carrying himself. That knee is excruciatingly painful.
Don't want to see him jump again.
I don't think he's going to. It's hard enough to compete in a world championship. To compete injured takes a lot of courage.
22-year-old Josef Zabavchik, he is obviously in pain. He told me on Thursday before the competition, again, that he was considering not coming because of his knee injury. That may well be going through his mind right now.
This is the jump that probably set the tone for the rest of the program. The triple flip jump at the beginning. Look how low he comes down on his knee, and that just had to tear it up. He goes up one, two, three times. It comes right down. Sets the pace for the rest of the routine.
You can see Zabavchik still obviously in a great deal of pain.
He's got to be wearing
the marks now for technical merit. 5-1 is the low score from the Swedish judge.
He's got to hurt more than just his knee. You know, I talked to him at the European Championships this year where he blew out Alexander Fadeev, and it just seemed like he was so ready to win this competition, to come here injured and to perform this way, and it's just a shame.
Artistic impression now, and low score of 5-0 from the Swedish judge. 5 minutes ago, Josef Zabavchik had a chance for the gold medal. Now he is completely out of the competition. He has taken himself out. Alexander Fadeev, with his performance, took himself out of it. And now, Mr. Second Place, the last skater, Brian Orser, who has twice skated to a silver medal in these championships, has a chance for gold.
Rick alone.
This is it. Opening night.
Brian, party of two?
You're on your way to the top.
Hey, it was just great.
No other beer is brewed and aged like exceptionally smooth Michelob.
Table for two?
Oh, that'll be about 45 minutes.
We did it.
Where you're going, it's Michelob.
Here's how we call the medal ceremony in last year's Worlds. The silver medalist now skating out onto the ice, the Canadian Brian Orser, thwarted again in his bid for a gold medal, but he'll stand silver once again. It would seem that Brian Orser is destined to step no further than the second place platform on the winner's stand. Mr. Second Place always seemed to play his sad song, Second Fiddle, to Scott Hamilton. Even in the 84 Olympics, Orser won both the short and the long skating programs, but could not master the figures, and so although it was close, it was still Brian Orser, Olympic silver medalist. And last year, after Hamilton had retired, Orser, now the heir apparent, finished the world championship where else?
Last year there was a lot of pressure on me because Scotty Hamilton had retired and I was the favorite to win. It was tough. I didn't realize until after the Worlds was over how much pressure was really there. And then afterwards it was just, you know, I could hardly move for a day. I was so sore just from the stress.
Brian Orser Arena.
Brian Orser has more than his own weight balanced over his two skates. He is the Canadian figure skating franchise. How many skaters in the world have an arena named after them? But Orser doesn't own the arena. He skates there and has had to fight for ice time with everyone else. Last year, he spent 2 hours a day not skating, but driving to and from rinks, snatching up precious ice time. Orser was holding practice for all his games on the road. This skating nomad had barely enough time to do anything but travel, and then put together rushed workouts, and then maybe lash together a lonely homemade meal in his apartment, and then wake up to ride the highways at daybreak.
So I was on the highway just as much as I was on the ice, and that took a lot out of me.
It may well have taken enough out of him to deny him last year's gold medal at the World Championships.
Sometimes you even think it's almost even a blessing in disguise what happened last year. You know, so you learn from it and you make sure you don't make the same mistakes the next time.
Well, there is not a skating fan in Canada who will tell you that Orser ever makes any mistakes. Right now, there is no Canadian man who skates any better. And in that country, that's a mouthful. But at 24 years old, how long can you be satisfied rock and rolling at home when the gold album is what you really want?
I feel the novelty of the World Championship is back. I'm not going to retire from skating until I'm world champion. And if I have to stay until 87, 88, Olympics in Calgary, I mean, you know, I'll be there. So, but I'm not going to retire until I'm world champion because I know that my skating is that quality that I'm capable of doing it.
Eyes, and they'll tell you that here is an athlete who will not, who certainly cannot say the word quit. He is the consummate student of his craft and the meticulous slave to perfection. What drives Orser and seems to almost drive him insane is written in black and white. Brian Orser, first in Canada, second in the world. Truth does nothing to discourage the Canadian champion. It only seems to make him more eager to fight back and to work harder. What can you deny a young man whose single goal in life is to finish what he set out to accomplish? When will the final results read, Brian Orser, world champion? Well, it may never happen, but who will ever say Brian Orser ever took time to quit trying? Here in Geneva, the time is here and now. This is Brian Orser's golden opportunity.
Brian Orser, Canada.
So now here in Geneva, the man they have called Mr. Second Place for so long now has the best chance of his lifetime to win the gold medal. Alexander Fadeev, the defending champion who was first entering the free skating, falling time and time again, and fell back down into second place behind Boitano. Now, if Orser wins the free skating program, He will win the gold medal for sure.
And that fall on the triple axel could have cost him. He's got another one planned later in the program. Expected to miss that. He hasn't missed it all week. It might have just made him doubt himself a little bit. The way he's been skating all week, it looks like he overdosed on Rocky movies.
Orser has actually lost 9 pounds since Christmas. He's in better shape than ever. He's been doing quadruples in practice, but he told me he will not do it. And this is long program. He wants to play it safe. With American Brian Boitano now in first place, does he have a chance to hang on for the gold?
I would say with the way Brian Orser is skating tonight, Brian Boitano might be the 1986 World Men's Champion.
Here in Geneva, a heavy Canadian contingent, but Orser, I would imagine, is not all that happy with that performance. He has skated better all week.
All week long, he's been invincible, and to come here tonight and to give a performance like this, it must be a huge disappointment for him.
Well, there's been a lot of pressure all week, and I would say because of it, Fadeev beat himself tonight, Zabavchik, and we'll wait for the scores for Orser.
Opening triple axel. Watch him go up, and he goes up on a little bit of a tilt here, and he cannot recover. He goes right down.
Boy, a nightmare for Brian Orser. This has been one heck of a day out here. Alexander Fadeev is all over the ice. Sabavchik is injured. The only one who skated a clean program is Brian Boitano, the American. Orser, who won the short and the long programs in the Olympic Games, figured to have an easy time of it with the gold, and now this happens.
I wasn't even tired.
You didn't look
not tired at all. Can't believe the first axel.
Me either.
I would say Brian Orser is at least stunned at this point.
Well, the way he skated all week, he might have just felt that maybe he just breezed through the long program and have no problems, and when you do that, sometimes you make a silly mistake.
Marks for technical merit. Whoa, 2 5-9s.
Oh my God.
And a bunch of 5 7s and 5 8s. But boy, this makes things interesting. We're going to have to wait for artistic impression. Brian Boitano could win the gold medal at this point. Fadeev obviously has no chance at it. Orser was the last one.
5-8, 5-7, 5-7, 5-8, 5-7, 5-8. Thank you.
Fadeev first.
Orser doesn't know what Fadeev is. Artistic impression coming up. Boitano has won the gold medal. Even with these scores, Brian Orser did not win the gold. He has the silver. One more time for, oh man, Mr. Second Place again this year.
He's got to know. He's got hurt. He had the medal in his hand. He just had to skate like he skated all week, and he'd be the world champion.
Thank you.
Second at the Olympic Games, second last year, the year before at the World Championships. He's on his way to John Misha Petkovic. John.
Brian, you had to know as you stepped on the ice that gold medal was within your grasp. What went wrong?
I don't know. I have absolutely no idea. I never felt so ready to go out and do it.
Well, you looked so relaxed, so ready for it while you were warming up before you got on the ice. Could you have been too relaxed?
I don't think so.
What happened on the triple axles?
I don't know. That's the first one I've missed all week.
It's been such a great week. We've watched you all week, and you've done so well. Just one of those things.
What could I say?
Good luck.
Thank you.
Stunned is the only way to describe Brian Orser. The important thing for the Americans, the story is Brian Boitano, our new world champion. Boitano, Orser, Fadeev, Josef Sobobcek ended up finishing back there in sixth place. Right now, let's go down to John Misha Petkovic, who's with our new world champion.
You won.
I can't believe it. It's like the most exciting moment of my life. Backstage when we were watching the screen and the things came up, I just grabbed my coach Linda and I think we hugged for 5 minutes. Everybody was yelling and it must have been the most exciting time of my whole life.
Well, I'll tell you, it's got to be so great that when everything works for you, you actually work. It works all the way and you win the gold medal.
I was just at Nationals. I was hoping to be here in top shape, not even wondering if I was going to win or not with my ankle. But I just went out there and tried to be a warrior, and it came through for me.
Well, you've worked awfully hard. It's worth every minute of it, I'm sure.
Yeah, and I'm going to go back and hopefully improve more next year and hopefully come back as stronger, way stronger.
Well, of course, next year it's going to be in Cincinnati.
That'll be nice, actually, to have the fans helped a lot. They're such an American team here that they just yelled and kept me going.
Great. Thanks very much, Brian.
Brian Boitano, who would have thought? Look at him there with the rest of the American team. There's Debbie Thomas, Karen Kadavy there, another American single skater. Who would have thought that Brian Boitano, from fourth place entering the free skating, would be able to come back and win the gold? A great story. Coming up, the Ice Dance Finals. Stay with us. We'll be back after this word and a message from your local stations. The ice dancing is one of my favorite parts of this championship. It combines ballet with drama and figure skating.
Well, this isn't a contest of jumps, spins. It's a contest of creativity.
What about Bestemyanov and Bukin now? They're first entering the free skate.
Well, Bestemyanov and Bukin are outrageous. They're very sexy, very dramatic. They kind of picked up where Torval and Dean left off, a concept style of free dance.
Just behind them, the other Soviet couple, right in second place, Klimova and Ponomarenko.
Well, they're more traditional. They're very artistic, and they base their free dances more in a traditional way of ballroom dancing. They're both very good. They're both very close going into the free dance, and it almost seems like the judges aren't sure which they prefer, the new wave or the traditional style of ice dance. It's going to be very interesting.
Here's a look at the way they stand entering the free dance. The three Soviets are in first, second, and third, and the Canadians in fourth, the two Americans in fifth and sixth. The first couple that we'll see from Canada, Tracy Wilson and Robert McCall, as you saw on those standings Canada. There, fourth entering the free dance. She is 24, he is 27.
And they're two of the nicest people you'll ever meet. They're going to show us a fun free dance. The Soviets are very dramatic and very serious. Tracy and Bob, just real enjoyable free dance. They waited a long time for this medal opportunity.
We'll be right back. Tracy Wilson and Robert McCall both skated with different partners before they teamed up in 1981. For the last 5 years, they have been Canadian National Ice Dance Champions. Last year in the World Championships, they finished fourth. And they would dearly love to get a medal here today. They've got a chance for the bronze. Tracy Wilson and Robert McCall. We don't have to tell you that there are a few folks from Canada here.
What a great free dance. They really delivered it with a lot of personality, some humor, and some incredible lifts. Another look at that lift they get towards the end of their free dance. I'm not really sure if they have a name for it, but it definitely is a benefit. She spins around on his back. She looks happy that they got through it too. Now she jumps right through his arms here. Very difficult routine.
Non-stop, Wilson and McCall waiting now for technical merit. Those marks are, well, those could be good enough actually to give them a bronze medal. The real fight for the gold is between the top two Soviet couples. Artistic impression, those are even better. So Wilson and McCall can get their first world championship medal. We'll be back with the battle for the gold in just a moment.
Dress has it all. Who says you can't love your work and the change it pays? Who says you can't have light beer with super?
Super premium taste and a less filling beer.
Michelob Light, oh yes you can. Have it all.
Sergei Ponomarenko. The Soviet couple in second place entering the free dance. She is 19, he is 25. They are the Olympic bronze medalists.
They represent the traditional style of free dance, that based on ballroom dancing. They show classic lines and four rhythms of music.
Their style of skating differs greatly from that of the other Soviet couple, Natalia Vestemianova and Andrei Bukin. They are in first place entering the free dance, and you'll be seeing them skate next. And Ponomarenko beat out Judy Blumberg and Michael Siebert in the Olympic Games for a bronze medal. These two got married after the World Championships in 1984. And Sergei Ponomarenko, second entering the free dance, are close enough to Vestemianova and Bukin to upset them for the gold here. These two were world silver medalists last year. 1985, they beat Vestemianova and Bukin in the Soviet Nationals. They have the talent to do it.
They certainly do, and they're skating very well.
Klimova and Ponomarenko.
Take a look at some of the footwork that makes this one of the most difficult free dances in the competition. Notice how they're constantly changing directions, trading places, and when you're doing that by yourself, it's hard enough, but when you have a partner next to you, it makes it next to impossible. Very technical, very difficult.
And the first set of scores we will get, for technical merit, they are 5-8s across the board.
5-8 is a decent mark, but for them being known as technical skaters, it really doesn't reflect the technical quality.
A 6-0, a perfect 6.0 for artistic impression. The rest, 5-9s.
There's only one mark that beats a 5-9, and that's a 6.0. So it's going to be difficult for Vesmin Ogunbukin to win this competition.
Rubesta Bianova and Andrei Bukin, the Soviet ice dancers in first place entering the free dance. They will be the next to skate. Dark, brooding, dramatic characters you see here are in sharp contrast to the two easygoing people I found when I interviewed them earlier this week. The two are known for their steamy routines on the ice. They are married, but not to each other.
My wife sometimes say me, you skate very hard with Natasha.
I think, and for expression Andrei, and we don't make special sex. I don't make this. I think it's normal for our expression.
Yeah. Our program, because it's our life.
Music. Skate and feel music, I think.
Natalia used to skate ladies' singles, but the suggestion came from her coach, Titania Tarasova, that she should try ice dance. She did, and this is the result.
Because in single I jump, but not so good. In practice I jump, in competition I fall. Yes, and Tarasova said to me, maybe you try. And I go try, and I like.
Patine Natalia Bestemianova.
So now they are here on the ice Union in Geneva, looking for another world title, defending world and European champions. Natalia Bestemianova, Andrei Bukin. Bestemianov and Bukin are dancing to a rhapsody on Paganini melodies by Rachmaninoff. The piano here is being played by Vladimir Krainiev, who is the husband of their coach, Titania Tarasova. In last year's Europeans, they received 7 perfect sixes for artistic impression.
Mm-hmm.
Torvald and Dean, they are changing the face of ice dancing. Bestemyanova and Bukin. They will need near-perfect scores in order to beat the other Soviet couple.
And this performance can't do it. I don't know what can. They were dramatic. Energy level was so high. They were magnificent.
It's interesting, they've been criticized in the past for using too much drama in their performances. As Torvald and Dean were criticized for many of the things they did in Ice Dance. Technical merit, the scores are much higher than Tomov and Ponomarenko. 5-9s and 5-8s. Now, artistic impression will tell the story. And as I mentioned before, that's where Bestemyanov and Bukin are at their best. Oh! 1, 2, 3 perfect 6-0s, 2 5-8s from the British and the Canadian judge.
Those marks are great, but it's going to be close. It could come down to one judge.
One more look at the balletic, dramatic figure skating moves of ice dance. Bestemyanov and Bukin. Let's go down now to John Misha Petkovic.
That was wonderful.
Thank you. We're happy now. Because all public was with us when we skate. We feel all public. It's beautiful.
Well, it was terrific. Do you think you won?
We hope. Sure.
We very hope what we won.
Will we see you in Cincinnati in the United States next year?
Yes, we want. We want skate in Cincinnati.
And you skate for the gold again?
Yeah.
Good luck. Thank you.
We'll be back with the results in a moment.
Come on, live a style in your life. No one could ever deny. You're on your way to the top and along the way. You've always known just who you are.
Where you're going, you've always known it.
No other beer is brewed and aged like exceptionally smooth Michelob.
Where you're going, it's Michelob.
Ice dancing, Bestemyanov and Bukin take the gold medal. Wilson and McCall, the Canadians, with their first world championship medal. The Americans finished 5th and 6th. It's been a great week of figure skating here at the World Championships, one of overpowering emotions as well. Could forget the 18-year-old pre-med student from Stanford University, Debbie Thomas. She led the competition almost from the very beginning. And when she finished, her ears were ringing from the cheers of those celebrating her gold medal. How about Katarina Witt, the East German beauty, who desperately tried but would be denied her third straight title. We saw the courageous return to competition of American Tiffany Chin. And she takes home a bronze medal from Geneva. And once again, the bad luck that this year claimed the performances of pair skaters Jill Watson and Peter Oppegaard. How about Alexander Fadeev, who held first place all week, only to suffer disaster in his long program and finish third? Canadian Brian Orser, learning that for the third straight year, he would be Mr. Second Place. And American Brian Boitano, who skated absolutely flawlessly to become the men's world champion. Two American world champions at the World Figure Skating Championships. And now, Brian Boitano will hear the sounds of his own national anthem.